Section 4.1. Section 4.1 is an intro into polynomials, and it talks about different polynomials and some aspects of them that will be important for us to use in later sections. So the first topic that I want to cover with you is something called the degree. The degree of the polynomial is basically the highest power. That's it. All you're looking for is what is the highest power of that polynomial. Secondly, would be what we call the leading coefficient. Now, what's a coefficient? Coefficient. Spring Show is forgetting how to spell. Okay, that is the, it's hard to write a full-out definition. It's easier for me to show you. A leading coefficient is basically the coefficient of that particular term. Now, the reason that they use the word leading is because it should be the first coefficient, but that's only if it's written in the proper order. For example, this one doesn't want to work. I can try another one. Let's see if this one works. There we go. 3x to the fourth plus 2x to the third minus 7x squared. There we go. There's a full long polynomial. What is the highest power? Huh? Right there, 4. So we would say that the degree is 4, because that's the highest power that I can see here. Okay. And we're talking about what we call polynomials in one variable. That means that I don't have a y and an x. I just have an x that I'm dealing with. And I don't have negative powers, which we're not going to worry about right now. So the degree is 4. Now, the leading coefficient is the number in front of that term. So that would be a 3. Because it's the leading coefficient, technically you could say it is the first coefficient. This is the first one you see. However, that only works, as I said, if they're written in the right order. What if, let me get my markers all mixed up here, what if we had a problem like this? 8x squared minus 7x to the fifth plus 2x to the fourth minus 18. Well, 8 is not my leading coefficient. It is the first, but that doesn't work right now because they're not written in the right order. You could do a couple things. You could rearrange and rewrite it and put them all in the right order, or you could just look at where's the highest power? It's right here. The highest power is 5. So my degree is 5. What is the coefficient of that term? Negative 7. There you go. Pretty simple and easy. Just real quick, scan, find the highest power. That's your degree. That's your leading coefficient. Okay? If I were to rewrite it in the proper order, it would have looked like this. Because you have to remember, when you write a polynomial, you write it in what we call descending powers, with descending powers. And you start with the highest and you work your way down. So don't forget the sign comes with it. All right. I could also ask, how many complex roots? What's a root? Well, a root is a solution. All right. There is a rule called the fundamental theorem of algebra that says that any polynomial, when it says equals 0, when it's written in that order, has the same number of roots as it does for the degree. Okay, so for example, if I have 0, what is the highest power? It's a squared. So that means there will be 2 roots. You know what? I'm going to switch that to a 12 because I don't want you to confuse which 2 I'm referring to. I don't care about this number. That is my leading coefficient, but that's not what I asked. I asked, how many complex roots. That means how many answers, whether they be real or imaginary, do I have? And I will have two. Later on, we'll get into how to find what those roots are. But for right now, I just need to be able to identify how many roots. So again, if it's not in the right order, that doesn't really matter. You can rewrite it in the right order, or you can look through it and say, there's my highest power. So it has three roots. Okay? All right. Now, I have this habit of making these fall on my head, so let's see if I can fix that today. All right. Let's see if this one works also. Last type of question that I might ask would be, all right, you know there's two roots or three roots, whatever. And my question to you is, would you be able to tell me if a certain number is a root? How would you know? All right, let's see. Okay, here's my question. I'll write it down over here. Is three a root? Well, there's only one way to know, and that would be to plug it in. Okay, I want to know if 3 works. So let's plug a 3 in for x. 3 squared minus 8 times 3 plus 15 equals 0. 3 squared is 9. 8 times 3 is 24. 9 minus 24 is a negative 15. Yes, it worked. So 3 is a root. If you were answering this question, and I would expect you to show work. So you could either show me this and then just say yes, or if you did it in your head or if you did it in a calculator, you would just need to say 0. Yes, because that's what I get when I plug a 3 in. I get 0, so yes, it's a root. New question. Is negative 2 a root? Same problem. And I'll pull a box around it. Okay. Now, is negative 2 a root? Well, let's find out. We're going to plug in negative 2. You have to be very careful when you plug in negatives because you're going to need parentheses. We do not want to accidentally square a negative 2 and get a negative as an answer. That wouldn't be correct. So your calculator will do that if you don't put these parentheses in. If you put it in just like this in your calculator, especially the graphing calculators, it will tell you the answer is negative 4. That's not correct. So you have to give it the right question. Calculator's correct, it's just we put it in wrong. So we have to put it in right. All right, negative 2 squared minus 8 times negative 2 plus 15 equals 0. Negative 2 squared is 4. Minus 8 times a minus 2 is a plus 16. 4 plus 16 is 20, plus 15 is 35. Does that equal 0? No. Again, I did express that you need to show work. You can either show me all of this, or you can just say 35. No, because I get 35 when I plug it in, so that is not a root. All right, there's section 4.1.